Today we're going to be talking about cart design for the hot dog business. This is one of our Euro carts, hand push hot dog carts. There's lots of carts on the market if you're thinking of coming into the hot dog business. I prefer the hand push type because it's easy to move. You can load it onto a trailer or into the back of a large estate car or small van and off you go. So don't require much space. If you did want something larger, we've also got towable carts, or towable carts are available on the market. With a towable cart, you do need to be careful if you are actually towing it on a motorway or going any very steep, windy roads, because they don't tow very well. I'm not saying don't buy a towable cart, but if you do get one, it's always worth having a larger trailer as well, where you can put it on the trailer for any large distances. So even with the towable carts, if you're going fast on motorways, long distances, it's always much better to go into the back of the van or on the trailer. Ours obviously aren't towable, these just go straight onto the trailer or the back of the van. When you're choosing a cart, there's certain things you need to be thinking of. When you're looking at the design of the cart, all carts were made in stainless steel. If there are any carts in aluminium tops, stay away from them. Aluminium is no good for the surface of a hot dog cart. All these carts need to be in 304 stainless steel. 304 is the grade of steel that's used in the food industry. Some of the Chinese carts you get are the 404, I think it is, or 403, 402, but it's the 304 you need. Don't get the other grades of stainless steel, they're not suitable for the hot dog or food industry. Where to buy the carts from? Obviously the US has a huge selection of carts, such as Dreammaker, Willys, Benz. There's a lot of big manufacturers out there and they make some really good carts. The problem is the expense, and also importing the cart is something you need to think of. You can also get some very cheap carts from China. What the Chinese don't tell you is the terms they sell them on is what they call FOB, which is freight on board. So you pay for the cart to go from China to Shanghai, to the port, or whichever port it's coming from. You then have to pay for getting the ship to the port in the UK, unloading, any customs charges, any duty, and also shipping it from there to your address. And it can add up to more than the cart has cost, much more. So if getting a cheap cart for $1,500, you're looking probably about £2,000 in fees getting it to this country. It can be less, can be more, depending on whereabouts you are in the UK and the type of carts you buy. But there are a lot of things to add on to there, so be very careful if you're getting from China. If you need any advice on importing, then please do give us a call and we can help you on that. When you look at the cart design itself, the important things you need to look at are the burners. We use automatic ignition. It isn't essential, but it is handy. We still always carry matches and lighters with us just in case anything goes wrong there. You don't want to be stuck with a hot dog cart that you can't light. And we've also got flame failure device. Again, it's not essential, but it's nice to have. One of the important things to look at when you're looking at cart design is the actual area you have for cooking your hot dogs. You need a 1-1 space. A 1-1 space in gastronomic terms. To think about when you're buying a hot dog cart is the actual space you have to cook on. It's important you get a minimum of a 1-1 space. Some of the larger towable carts may be a 1.5, but you need a minimum of a 1-1 space, which in gastronomic terms is this size. This means you can cook a range of things by using different pans. For instance, a 1-1 space will fit 3 1/3 dishes. Bars, 1/4 dishes, and you have an option to mix and match, and you obviously have more dishes as well. You can also use a 1.5 dishes, so 2 1.5 dishes would fit in, but it gives you a huge amount of options if you have a 1-1 space. Some cars will dishes, which again you can change to 1-9 dishes, 2-1-6 dishes, or just have the 1/3 dishes. So again, you're much more open to what you can sell and how you can put your produce in there and your condiments. So look at the size of the dishes that are used in these spaces. Sometimes these are spaced out, so you've just got a 1-6 dish in each one, but again, you're limited to what you can use them for. We've got sauce holders on this card. Having sauce holders, very useful. If they're just rested on the side, there is a chance of people knocking them off on the floor, and then you have to replace your sauce bottle because of contamination. So it's much better to have them in there. The thing with shelves, with large shelves, if you have too much space on them, you have to be careful when people come along, especially if you're at an event at night where people have been drinking, for putting the beer on your cart. You need to get them to stop doing that straight away, because it only takes one drunk to knock the beer, and that's your complete produce ruined. So do be careful where people put drinks. When you're looking at the design again, you need to be looking at where the produce are. Here's the condiment dishes. So if I'm standing serving the hot dogs, I can get them without having to lean over the cart too much. If you're leaning a long time, it really hurts your back when you stretch it out for condiments. So keep everything you use a lot right close to you. We've also got a little shelf on the cart where you can put the bread buns. So if you're steaming the bread buns, or if you have a hot dog bread bun holder, then you can put them here, and it just makes it a lot easier than having to have to get individual buns from the shelf. Again, it's easy when you're doing it once or twice, but after a full day of trading, it really hurts your back having to lean over the cart. When you look at the cart in general, a lot of carts will have a cool box here. It can be useful, especially some if you want to put cool drinks in, but we find a lot of people will want to use this space for a griddle, hot plate, so they can serve a wider variety of products. As long as there's a space somewhere to keep a cooler box, that's what you really need. Such as a large door where a cooler box will easily fit. When you get to the event, most people will get a cooler box and a box for the bread and put it close to them either side. So you've got easy access to drinks, easy access to cooler box dogs, whatever you're using. Another thing we need to think about when we're looking at the card is for your hygiene certificate. Excuse me. Another thing we need to think about when we're looking at cards is hygiene. Everything has to be able to wipe down. And also things need to come out so you can clean them. If anything's fixed in place, then it's probably not a great design on the card, because it means you having to get in there and wash them every time rather than be able to take them out and take them to a dishwasher. So look at everything that needs to come out. You need to be able to wipe the surfaces down easily. You also need a sink with a supply of clean water. It's much better if you can have warm water. There are ways of making warm water on carts, but it does put the price of the cart up. We found the cheapest way to get warm water is use a cold water system, but instead of running the pipe into the cold water barrel, we use a large thermos flask filled with hot water and put the tube straight into the flask. And that way you've got a constant supply of warm water. And of course, with having a burner and pans, we've got a way of supplying warm water to the flask. You can always heat up some water and then pour it in there. So you'll always have warm water on tap, and that's by far the best, most economical way to get a warm water system on the cart. The other ways are getting a hand wash sink, which can fit on the side of the cart and runs off a 12-volt battery. They are very good. The health at the sides of the cart and the place that you can advertise. This box is the main place people put their menus and stickers. This box itself can have to be changed. If you've seen some of our other videos looking at the cart, so this whole panel will come off and you can see the produce inside. But it is a nice area for putting designs on, and your website address, menus, pictures of hot dogs. So really jazz the carts up as much as you can. It makes a massive difference to sales. Even though these carts are really stunning on their own, having some extras on makes a big difference. This is something we use a lot, these metal signs, tin signs, and they're brilliant. Just saying hot dogs on, but we have them pinned to the side of the cart. It makes a big difference, really jazzes up the cart. So it's well worth thinking about how you can individually personalize your hot dog carts to make them really stand out. And that's not going back on the wall now, I've done that a little bit here. Other things to think about when you're buying the cart is where do you put the gas and the size of the gas holder. Some of the American carts and the Chinese carts, which are built for the American market really, will have a smaller gas holder or a really big gas holder depending on size. Make sure you get one for your UK gas bottle. It just needs to be secure to the cart so the gas bottle's not going to go anywhere. Think about your wheels. How do you stop the cart from rolling off? You need to buy some wooden chocks, wooden blocks, put them underneath the wheel, it really secures them. The front casters on these have a lock, so you can push them down and stop the cart rolling off, but you need to think about how you move the cart around. If you are moving around, carts can be very strange things to push. It's not like pushing a pram. These things can be very heavy. Although it's a lightweight cart, when it's fully laden with a gas bottle on the front and the water containers full of produce, all the weight is towards the front caster. If you're on a slight hill, you'll find the cart wants to roll down it, and you'll not be able to hold it with just the handles. So you kind of push the cart from the side, guiding it. So think about the way of the wheels and the setout. Don't let the cart run away with you. You need to be able to secure it once you get to the place. It's always better if it's your first time setting up that you know you have a little practice before you actually go out there selling. These are things that'll come as you get more experience in the hot dog business. If you're going to be moving the cart around, you need to look at the size of the cart. Obviously, can you load it onto a trailer yourself? Is it easy to put on there? Do the top boxes remove so it'll fit into a large estate or a van? So have a look at those things when you're actually buying a cart. A lot of the American systems, this is where you'll hold your water. So you've got the whole top of the cart is taken for water, and it can't be removed from the actual cart. Which kind of limits to what you're going to be using for. You'll either be towing it or putting it into a large van if the top box doesn't come off. The handy thing about having a top box that's removable is once it is removed, like this, it gives you a huge space for selling other items. You can put whatever you want on there to sell. You can make it into a candy cart, a sweet cart, put a candy floss machine on there, sell whatever you want really. We're talking about attracting people to your cart, some of the things you can do. Lights are brilliant. Obviously in winter time in the UK, it gets dark very soon, so you want to be lighting your cart up. Once you've got your parasol on there, think about parasol lights and LED lights. Perhaps put a bigger battery on, suitable for a winter, using a lot of power. These carts have the LEDs on, which are brilliant, really attract people. If you wanted more LEDs, you can put those on the cart. But they make a big difference to people coming over and actually buying your produce. People in the big burger vans and the pizza vans or whatever sort of big catering trailers they have are going to hate you, because you have a smaller cart,